of a prayer is called rakah, but sometimes units of a prayer, okay? Units of the prayer. One rakah is one unit. So how many units of prayers for sunnah, nafal, witr in different prayers? Can you tell me, Noor Muhammad? Request.
Farz or?
All. Every.
All
Sir, can I tell?
Be quick. Noor Muhammad is telling. Let him tell.
Sir, all I don't know.
Why you don't know? Why?
Sir, actually,
how many in Fajr? Or...
Ji? Sir, can I tell?
Ji Abdur Rahman sir, tell everyone. And I will ask everyone. Listen sir, carefully.
We have to pray two sunnahs before the namaz, and after those two sunnahs, we have to pray two rakat fajr, and then for zuhr, sir,
listen,
before we have to.
Abdurrahman.
Yes,
Abdurrahman. You see, when we have to say, we have to offer two units sunnah. We have to offer, not pray, offer.
Okay. We have to offer two units sunnah before the fajr prayer.
Yes.
Before the fajr prayer, and then
we have to. Abdurrahman sir, Abdurrahman sir, tell in this way. Yes. We have to offer two units sunnah and two unit farz. Okay.
Okay.
And of course, you will mention the sunnah is rawatib or not. You know, rawatib Arabic. In Urdu is Sunnat Muakkada, which is compulsory. So you have to tell in the prayer of Fajr, we have to offer two units Sunnah, which are Sunnah Ratiba or Sunnah Muakkada, and then two units of Farz prayer. Farz mean obligatory. Ji,
yes.
I just told on some people, they have raised hand. Ji, Abdul Rafi.
Yes, sir.
Your hand is up. You want
sorry,
to ask sir. Something or tell something?
Sorry.
Ji Abdurrahman, continue, beta.
Okay, sir. Sir, so two sunnatul muakkada and we have to offer two units of first prayer for Fajr. And then for Zohar, four. Units we have to offer four units of sunnah before zuhr, which is sunnat al muakkada, and then four units of prayer, and two units which is not sunnah. Two units of sunnah prayer, and then we have to offer Isha. We have to offer four units, and we have for two sunnah units, and then there is witr. And for witr, there are many like Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But with us as one rakat, three rakats and five and till 11 he have offered. So it sir, it is in this way.
Abdurrahman, how many witr rakat?
Sir, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam offered in many types. Like he offered in 1, 3, 5, 7, and 11.
You see, so Abdurrahman, listen, mera beta. Listen me. Witr is odd numbered prayer, so one rakat or three rakats, okay? Maximum, these are the two situations to offer odd numbered prayer. But in case 5, 7, 9, 11, as you told, you see, he would offer. Tahajjud prayer, two units to sometime eight units, two in one go, and then in another go two more, And at the end of witr, the tahajjud prayer, he would offer this witr prayer, a one unit or three units.
Okay.
Rafi, can you tell me the number of rak'ah in each prayer from Fajr till Isha?
Yes, sir.
Tell.
Sir, in Fajr there is two sunnat and two farz. In Zohar there are four sunnat, four farz and two sunnat. In Asr there are four farz. In Maghrib there are three farz and two sunnat. In Isha there are four sunnat, four farz, two sunnat and three witr.
Okay, so this is the standard, right? What is the difference between sunnah muakkada and ghair muakkada, or sometimes sunnah ratiba or non ratiba? You see in your book there is a column sunnah ghair muakkada, so it means there is sunnah which is muakkada and ghair muakkada. What is this? Can you know? Can you tell me? Anyone in this class?
Said that the Prophet only sometimes prayed.
So sometime he offered, that is known as ghair muakkada. Okay. And it means you can offer and you can skip these also. Now coming to the performance of prayer. You see, my rabbit, in the exam, you might be asked by the examiner to describe the procedure of one unit of prayer. You might be asked to describe the procedure of one unit of salah, one unit of prayer, one rak'ah. Sometimes you might be asked to describe the procedures of two units of salah. So in this, you will mention the physical postures as well. And in between, you will tell what you are supposed to, what you are required to do in different postures. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Can any one of you tell me at your own about this performance of one unit of salah, yani how do we do, or what is the procedure, or what are these postures called, which posture is followed by which posture, what we do first and then anyone in this class? No one?
Then first we do the niyat, then we say Allah Akbar. After saying Allah Akbar, we say Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdihi wa tabarakta. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdihi wa tabarakta ismuka wa ta'ala jadduka wa la ilaha ghayruk. Then we will recite Surah Fatiha. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. After that we will recite any surah.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. What is takbir tahrima? What is takbir tahrima or takbir ula?
We raise both our hands and say Allahu Akbar.
Okay. So first of all, we do the act which is known as Takbir-e-Ula. Takbir-e-Ula is to say Allahu Akbar first time. And what movements we do, what posture we take in this Takbir-e-Ula?
So we raise both of our hands with the thumb touching the back of our ears.
So we raise both of our hands and our palms should be facing toward Qibla. And we raise our hands up till the level of our shoulders, or it can, or our thumbs can touch the ear lobes. And when we raise our hands up till this level, we have to say Allahu Akbar. Now this all proceedings and saying is known as Takbir-e-Ula or Takbir-e-Tahreema. Clear?
Yes, sir.
And what is the next posture? What is the next position?
Just to stand straight with our hands above our...
No. What this position is called?
Ruku.
No. Ruku? Guru Muhammad. This portion is called Qiyam. Qiyam means standing erect, standing straight.
Sir, I thought you were talking when about when we put our hands on the knees.
I said to you, what is the next posture after Takbir-e-Tahreema? The next is Qiyam. In Qiyam, we stand straight and we fold our hands right over the left and on the navel or just below the navel. On the navel or just below the navel. And some people they place on the chest and some they do not even fold. So this posture is known as Qiyam. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And whatever we recite in Qiyam, that is known as Qiraat. Qiyam is standing posture when the worshippers, they stand straight. They fold their hands right over the left and they place these hands on their navel or just below the navel. Some people you might have seen, they place their hands on their chest. And some even they do not fold even. So their standing posture is known as Qiyam, standing posture. And whatever we recite during this posture, that is called Qiraat. The recitation. And this Qiraat consists of three things. Abdurrahman, what are these three things? Ji Abdurrahman Sahib, where are you? He is not answering. Muhammad Ashar.
Yes, sir.
What recite?
What, sir?
When we offer Salah, while... Yes. Can you hear me, Muhammad Ashraf?
Yes, sir.
While offering Salah in Qiyam, when we stand, when we fold our hands, we used to recite something. That recitation is called Qiraat. And by the way, what we recite, what things we recite in that?
So first we recite like Subhanakallah wa bihamdika wa tabarak qasmuk wa ta'ala jaddu wa la ilaha illa ghayruk.
Okay, this is called what? This is called Sana. Sana means the praise of Allah. Okay. And the, what is next, Ashar?
Sir, then we say A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajeem, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Then we recite Surah Al-Fatiha.
Okay. When we say A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajeem, this is called Ta'awwuz. This is called what?
Ta'awwuz.
Ta'awwuz. And then we say Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. This is called what?
Tasmiyah.
Tasmiyah. Bismillah Rahman Rahim is called Tasmiyah. And what we recite afterward? Ashar.
Yes, sir.
Sir, Suratul Fatiha.
Sir, then Surah Fatiha.
Okay, good. And what we recite after Surah Fatiha, Ashar?
Sir, any small surah, Suratul
Ikhlas. I'm asking Ashar at the moment. Let him say, Bita. Huh?
So we can recite Surah Ikhlas or any other small surah.
Any, not big surah.
Like we can, but preferably we do small surah.
Now why we prefer small surahs? Actually, we have not memorized the big surahs.
Okay? Yes.
You see, when we want something or money, we want big money, huh?
Yes.
But when we want to give, we have to give. We prefer short things. No, this is not the case. So the case is we have to recite one surah, at least one surah, or at least three verses. One surah of the Quran or at least three verses. Because the shortest surah, Surah Kausar, got three verses. And you can recite any big surah, long surah. There are no compulsion. Only compulsion is not less than the length of Surah Kausar. Do you understand my point?
Yes, sir.
But if you happen to recite only Ayatul Kursi is only one ayat, but there are 10 phrases in it. You know, it is also a lengthy one. So in the case of Ayatul Kursi, you can only recite Ayatul Kursi. So while you stand up, you have to recite Sana, then Surah Fatiha, and then another Surah of the Holy Quran. This oral recitation is called what? Qiraat.
Qiraat.
Okay. And this standing posture is called what?
Qiyam.
Qiyam or the standing position. Now, Zain Ahmad Irfan, what is the next posture and what we call it and what we do there? Zain Ahmad Irfan.
Yes, sir.
Haji, what is followed by Qiyam?
Sir, after Qiyam, we do Ruku.
We do Ruku, and the Ruku is called in English what? It is called bowing or inclination. Bowing, B-O-W-I-N-G, bowing or inclination. So, what position we take in that? Where we put our hands, where we have to look?
Sir, we have to look down and put our hands on our knees.
Where, look down, where we have to look down? where we have to place our back and knees and hands? What should be the position?
Sir, we place our hands on our knees and bend down.
Bend down? How we bend down? In what way we should bend down? Where should be our neck and back? Let me ask Abdul Rafi, he's raising hand. Huh, Abdul Rafi?
Sir, our neck and back should be straight.
Should be straight, horizontal or vertical?
Vertical, horizontal, sir.
Horizontal to what? To ground.
Yes, sir.
And we should fix our gaze at what point?
Sir, at our toes.
Okay, nails or sometime the point of sujood. And what do we say during this posture?
Subhanallah Rabbi al-Azim.
How many times minimum?
Three times.
Maximum?
Sir, any odd number, but any odd number.
Okay, Ahmad Alam, you are right. Any odd number time you can say this, but it should be odd number. It might be 5 or 7 or 9 or 11. Okay. And this posture is called as Ruku or inclination. And this saying of Subhana Rabbi Al Ala or Subhana Rabbi Al Azim, this is called glorification of Allah. What this is called? Glorification of Allah. Zain Ahmed Irfan, can you explain how do we do this ruku and what do we say? Zain Ahmed.
Yes, sir.
why are you not answering? Did you hear what did I say?
Yes, sir.
So please tell me what I say. Give me the answer.
Sir, our neck and back should be straight horizontal to the ground. We say Subhana Rabbi al-Azim 3 times minimum and any odd number maximum.
While we bow, where we have to keep our hands?
Hands on the knees.
And looking at the point of your sujood. This is called what?
Ruku.
Okay, you all should remember this. If you are coming to the masjid and you happen to get late, but you arrived in the masjid when Imam was already in Ruku, so you have to say Allahu Akbar and you have to slightly fold your hands before joining in Ruku. And if you happen to join in this way, so you have participated in that whole of the rakah. Do you understand my point?
Yes, sir.
Ji, beta.
Sir, during ruku, should our knees be always straight or could they be bent?
But if you are not old person, if you don't have any problem, these should be straight. And if you are old person, there are some disease or a problem, then the ruling is different. Ahmed Siddiqui Sahib.
Okay,
clear?
Sir.
Ahmed Siddiqui, tell me what we do after this ruku and that is called what?
Sir, after ruku, we do Samiallahu Liman Hamida and Rabbana Walakkal Hamd. And then we do Allahu Akbar and go to Sishta.
Just a minute, mera beta. When we say Sami Allahu Liman Hamida, that we do while we are already in the ruku position or we stand straight?
We stand straight.
This standing straight is called what?
Qoma.
Good, Abdurrahman. Shabash. So that standing straight, immediately after ruku for a while, for a very short span of time, that is called qoma. And if you do not happen to do this, and if you miss this, if you don't do this, then salah will be invalid. Yani you have to stand up for a while straight. Sami Allahu Liman Hamida, you have to say, and then what you have to say? Ahmed Siddiqui Sahib.
Rabbana wa lakal hamd.
So this standing posture is called qoma. Okay. Then we do what?
Sajida.
In it we read Subhana Rabbi al-Ala 3 times.
Abdurrahman, when I was asking, you was not responding. And now
sir, please, my network was not working.
So you should have a healthy networking, okay?
Okay,
feed your network well. Okay, Ji Ahmed Siddiqui Sahib.
Yes, sir.
What
sir,
do we do?
Sir, then we go to Sajda and say Subhan Rabbi al-Ala minimum 3 times.
Okay, next posture is called Sujood. And how many times we have to do Sujood in one rakah?
2 times.
Twice.
Yes.
And what do we say in sujood?
Subhana Rabbi al-Azha.
How many times?
Minimum 3 times.
Maximum?
We can say any odd number.
Odd number. And now you tell me which body parts must be placed on ground while doing sajda.
Sir, sir, our head, our nose, our feet and our knees, our whole leg.
Ji Abdurrahman.
Sir, can I tell? Sir, our this forehead, our nose, our hands, our knees, our feet, and this is seven. Only seven parts should be.
Good, good. So you have to keep your these body parts on the ground. Your nose and forehead. So this is your face actually. Any your forehead and your nose must be touching the ground while sujood. You might have seen some people, they do not touch the ground with their nose. They don't keep their nose on the ground. So it is not the perfect way to do sujood. And then you have to keep your palms on the hand, on the ground, not your forearm. Only your palms must be touching. Rest of your arm must be up on the ground. Then you have to keep your knees and you have to touch the ground with your toes. Something happened.
Yes, sir.
Abdurrahman, what did you do? Only you are appearing on the screen.
So he turned on his camera.
No, but highlight, how you do this highlight yourself?
Sir, I did not do anything.
Sir, if you go and click on the three dot, there is an option and it says that spotlight on. It means that, sir, when Abdurrahman speaks or his camera is on, so his spotlight means that it will highlight on top.
But I yes. can't do this now.
Sir, if agar ek bande ne camera khole to sir wahi aayega.
Agar sir bahut se ladkon ne dikhaye to wo divide ho jayega na ek screen to nahi.
So that was in the control of the presenter actually, but I don't know, this is the change.
No, sir, I did not do anything. I just opened my camera.
Okay, no problem.
Sir, it is by default. Sir, it is by default.
Okay. Thank you very much. So, sujood we have discussed. So, there are two sujood and this is the way to do the sujood. Seven body parts must be on the ground. If you happen to lift any body part while you are sujood, so that sujood will be invalid. Ji Abdurrahman, your hand is up. What do you want to say?
Sir, I wanted to tell about the the time when we sit between two sujood and what.
So I will ask you, okay, let me ask the class and if they give the answer, that's good. Otherwise you will give me the answer. Now the question is, when we sit between two sujood, you have to sit properly for a while. Okay, you have to sit like you sit in qaada. Now, the pause between two sujood is called what? Anyone in this class except Abdurrahman?
Sir, Jalsa.
Jalsa, good. Yes, and Abdurrahman is right.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So, Jalsa is a must. Okay, you have to sit. There must be a gap in between two sujood. And if you do not do this gap, if you do not do this jalsa, prayer will be invalid. So this is the complete procedure of one unit. So what will be the procedure of two units of prayer, Ahmed Nawaz?
Sir, can I ask you something?
Ji, ask something.
Sir, in Jalsa, we also say something.
Yes, these are, prayers which you can make. But this is not compulsory, right?
Okay, sir.
You can do this is optional. You can make this dua. But this is not, the compulsory part. So, can Ahmed Nawaz tell us how do we do two units of the prayer? Let's see what he is telling us, Ahmed Nawaz. Ahmed Nawaz is not telling. He is not willing to tell. Ji Muhammad Kundi Sahib. Now you tell us, how do we do 2 units of Salah? Can you hear me, Muhammad Kundi?
Yes, sir.
Please tell us then, how do we do 2 units of Salah?
Sir, unit mean, sir, from the BSR,
unit,
I've
unit mean unit mean rakat.
Sir, so I have to tell this, first of all, we have to start the, first of all, you have to start, we have to have niyat for the prayer, and then you have to start it by saying Allahu Akbar, and you have to say Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika tabarak ismuka wa ta'ala jitu wa la ghayruk.
Let me know. No, we have discussed. Okay, I tell you briefly. In the first, in the one unit of prayer, you have to do this takbir-e-tahreema, and you have to explain how do we do that. Then you have to tell that you have to do qiyam, and in qiyam you have to recite sana, surah Fatiha, followed by another surah. And after the completion of qiraat, you have to do ruku. And in ruku, what you have to do, what you have to say, you will tell. And then up till 2 sujood, what we do in second rakat after second sajda?
So like this you have to tell?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
You can say the first rakah is same as we discussed, but once you finish the one unit of prayer, you have to stand up for the second rakah, and you have to repeat all that up till the second sujood. And what you are supposed to do after second sujood, that is the point which you have to tell us. Otherwise, Abdurrahman.
Sir, after a second rakat, after sujood, sir, you have to sit down, and then we have to do, we have to say attayyatu lillahi, this whole dua, and then we have to stand up. Then we have to stand up.
You are offering only 2 units of prayer, then why you stand up?
Sir, when you say attayyatu lillahi, when you sit down, and then after that, you have to stand up.
Why you have to stand up, bhai? You have
talking about Fajr Namaz.
I am talking about only 2 units of prayer, bhai. Ji Abdurrahman
sir, it is called Tashahud, and when we said.
No. Abdurrahman.
Yes, sir.
After the second sujood, we keep on sitting as we sit in Jalsa, right?
Yes.
So
yes.
After the second sujood, the sitting posture is known. This is called Qada. And what we recite in between, that is known as Tashahud. Now tell me what we recite in that.
Tahiyyatu lillahi wa salawatu wa tayyibatu wa salamu alayka ya nabiyya rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alayna wa ala ibadillahi salihin. Ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashadu anna Muhammadan abduhu rasuluh. Then the durud sharif. Allahumma salli ala
Muhammad. What do you have to do when you say ashadu an la ilaha illallah?
Sir, we have to raise over this ungli.
Which ungli? Index finger of the right hand.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then what you have to say?
Sir, then durud sharif, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Muhammadin kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala Ibrahim innaka Hamidum Majid. Wa barik ala Muhammadin wa ala Muhammadin kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala Ibrahim innaka Hamidum Majid. Then rabb ij'alni muqimas salati wa min dhurriyyati, rabbana taqabbal du'a, rabbana ighfir li wa li walidayya wal mu'minina yawma yaqumul hisab. Then assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
So is it compulsory to recite only rabb ij'alni, or can we recite any other dua?
Sir, we can recite any other dua.
Okay, good. What is the last act of the prayer?
Sir, we have to do salam first, right, then left. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullah, and then assalamu alaikum warahmatullah.
This last act is called what?
Taslima, I think so.
Only taslim.
Yeah, taslim.
So, if you happen to write all these things which we have discussed, it means that you will tell the examiner that you know how to offer 2 units of prayer, and examiner will give you full marks. Clear?
Allah. Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good. And now you see, I have given you a homework for this week, and I have sent this in your diary as well. Similarly, this is in your Islamic study channel as well. So you have to
set